the greatest hero any world has ever known. Captain Star journeyed the universe in his ship, The Boiling Hell. His orders, to discover new worlds, name them after himself, and then sell them things. One day, The Boiling Hell arrived at the ragged edge of the universe, where Captain Star and his crew, Navigator Black, Atomic Engine Stoker Linz Jones, and First Officer Scarlet, waited for orders from Mission Control. And waited. And waited. And waited.
My bed in here so that I don't miss any meals.
Yes, Captain.
Put the food down there. Wake me when it's cooled, would you?
It's a very common condition among heroes, sir. They often feel that it's not worth getting up unless they're going to save the universe. With that in mind, I've invented the atomic alarm clock. It's wired to the ship's missile silo. When the alarm goes off here, the missile launchers are primed. You then have exactly 21 minutes to get from bed to the bridge.
Only 21.
Otherwise, the missile will be launched. I have taken the liberty of aiming the missile at Mission Control, Captain. Mission Control is the largest object in creation. If you don't switch off the missile in time, it'll be destroyed along with thousands of innocent lives.
Excellent, Scarlet. Now, if you don't mind.
21 minutes to save Mission Control and thousands of innocent lives. Help, Captain Star, help. Please wake up, Captain Star. Are you awake yet, Captain Star? Captain...
Captain, look!
Can't stop now, Jones.
A model rocket. It's the Boiling Hell.
Just like the real thing.
But smaller.
You must have a look, Captain.
20 minutes to prevent a missile attack on Mission Control.
I suppose I can give you a few minutes.
The emergency merchandise delivery chute has miniature garden furniture. It's got everything
except the missile.
Not much of a toy without a missile.
It even flies, Captain.
Or it should do.
It should be flying, right? Why isn't anything happening?
Well, if you'll excuse me, Jones, I must go and save thousands of innocent lives. Stop! Jones! Stop it!
I'm trying, Captain. It
wasn't supposed to work this way.
Gone.
Thousands of innocent lives will be lost, and we sit here, helpless to do anything. Marooned.
And it's all my fault.
Quite.
Oh, marooned, and without a rocket.
That's what marooned means, Black.
Well, I'm sure the captain could still save the day, if he had a rocket, that is.
I blame me.
So do I.
So do I.
So do I. And me.
Me too.
Could we order a new rocket from Mission Control?
In a very short time, Mission Control will be a heap of weightless rubble.
Oh, yes. More coffee?
Marooned. Disgraced.
I'm tired.
What's the use?
Sorry about the wall. That old rocket of mine tends to fly away with you.
Rocket?
Good heavens, Captain Star! What are you doing in bed, man? It's a lovely day in space.
Rocket?
There she is. The curdled glory. Fattest ship of her class. What do you think?
No fatter than the boiling ham, I should think. Certainly not.
Men, get on board. Full speed ahead. We have, 17 minutes or so to save the universe.
17 minutes, no problem. I've helped you out of sticky situations before now, Star.
Really? How's that,
Bloater, surely you remember. Back at the Captain's Academy. Sticky situation?
Someone dispose of this for me. It's very sticky.
Me, I will.
Stop!
He noticed me.
Captain, I've picked up the Boiling Hell's homing beacon.
But Captain, it's coming from the Junk Nebula.
Terrific! The Junk Nebula! Mysterious and deadly repository of all the junk in creation. This is the life, A-Star!
Of course, no one has ever gone into the Junk Nebula and come out alive.
My kind of odds. Careful, Black. Hard right.
Sorry, Captain. Your other right, Black. Oh, yes, of course. Sorry, Captain, my mistake. Silly me. Oh, dear.
We're doomed. And it's all my fault.
We've established that, Jones. Do you mind, Jones?
There must be something I can do to make up, Captain.
Yes, Jones. I think we'd all be grateful if you went and washed those socks.
Aye, aye, Captain. Right away.
Brilliant, Star. Brilliant. Wash your socks. Just what I was going to say.
Star, has it struck you that Bloater is a bit too enthusiastic about you?
Too enthusiastic? No. I think he's just about right.
Laundromat. On the Boiling Hell, it was next to the airlock. Before we dismantled it, of course. This way? Oh, do you mind? That way, then. Please. Left? Right. Right, then. Right. No!
That was it, Captain. We missed it.
Fascinating. The crushing machines which were placed here back when the nebula was a simple space dump seem to have evolved into savage life forms.
Really? How do you know?
Because they're chasing us.
Hard about.
No. On TV, you say. Evasive action.
This isn't TV. This is life.
Oh, not for much longer.
We can't outrun them, Captain.
Then we'll just have to head right forward.
Today's breakfast specials are lobster ruffles with pan chutney. Halibut surprise.
Straight ahead, Scarlet. Scarlet, prepare for full speed. Wait for it. Full speed. I must admit, this old crate of yours handles like a dream, Blower.
Glad you like it, Star. The name's Bloater, by the way.
Private. Could this be the laundromat? A private laundromat, perhaps? I've never heard of a private laundromat. Hello? Oh, my.
Star of Space.
It's Star of Space.
Ooh, I'll save you, Captain.
It's all right, Smith. I can save myself. You must do what you do. Jones. I need a hand. Jones.
Here I am, Captain.
This must be Blouter's room. Perhaps he could lend me some socks. My goodness. He's quite a fan of Captain Star. Fanatic fan, fantastically fanatic. Some kind of chocolate wrapper. Oh, look. Captain Star pajamas, so stretchy.
Our best, best friend.
I've picked up the Boiling Hell's homing beacon. We're close.
Thundering rockets. What's that?
Captain, it's a rust storm. It could reduce our ship to a pile of iron filings in seconds.
Evasive action, Black!
That's more like it, Star! Evasive action!
But, Captain, the Boiling Hell's signal is coming from within the storm.
Into the storm, Black! That's what Captain Star would do!
Yes, yes, into the storm. And Scarlet, pass me the arc sun catalog.
How are you going to tell the captain you can't even find the laundromat?
Me? Why don't you tell him?
Me?
Well, I don't.
This ought to do it. Scarlet, take the catalog number. Garden Gnomes, selection 23A. 4 tons of them.
Captain Blouter, I've lost the laundromat. Misplaced it. Can't find it at the moment. Will you show me the way?
Go away! We're trying to save the universe!
Quite all right, mister. I can save the universe myself. You run along with Jones.
Right. Of course, Captain Star, sir. Come on, Jones.
Drag me away from the captain, would you?
Interpose your socks between me and my best friend. I'll show you.
But this is not the laundromat. This is the airlock.
Right first time, you nine-headed freak.
Thank you for selecting the option Mango Bear Trap Gopher. Airlock now in operation. In 30 seconds, all the air will be removed from the chamber and its contents will be ejected into space. Have a nice day.
Ready with those garden gnomes, Scarlet?
Ready, Captain.
The garden gnome should seed the storm, causing the rust particles to crystallize and fall harmlessly to the bottom of space.
I realize that, Captain.
Nine-headed spacesuit. And it's just my size.
Hurrah!
And it's my colour, too. What an amazing coincidence.
Space back.
any second. I don't understand. Where's the ship? I'm still getting the signal.
Magnification. It's the homing beacon.
If this ship should dare to roam, turn it round and send it home.
Someone sent it into the Junk Nebula on a rocket in order to lead us on a wild goose chase.
That means the Boiling Hell could be anywhere in the universe.
Yes, and we have only 4 minutes until... the atomic alarm. We'll never save Mission Control now.
That'll teach those imbeciles to ignore the great Captain Star.
What did Mission Control ever do for us? Without them, well, free to roam the universe, just the two of us.
Mister, to devil.
It's bloated. How many times?
Your seats, everybody. Jones, where did you find a nine-headed spacesuit? With a broken head?
Luckily, there was a nine-headed spacesuit in the airlock, hanging up on a peg, thank goodness.
In the airlock?
He threw me into the airlock and told me it was the laundromat. The truth is, there is no laundromat on this ship.
No laundromat?
What kind of rocket has no laundromat?
My rocket has no laundromat.
And that was different. That was my fault. At least you never pretended there was a laundromat.
No laundromat? And a nine-headed suit? Of course!
Blaster, you diabolical fiend!
Water!
There is only one ship in this class without a laundromat. The Boiling Hell isn't lost! This is the Boiling Hell! Obviously, Bloater used some kind of super magnetic attraction device to steal and redecorate the Boiling Hell. The missile!
No! You spoiled everything! With Mission Control gone, we can have adventure after adventure!
Done it! He's shut off the missile!
I think you'll find you've deactivated the buzzer, but not the missile.
After it!
You'll never catch it in this old heap. Mission Control will be destroyed.
I think you'll find that you have seriously underestimated the abilities of atomic engine stoker Limbs Jones.
Oh, I was in a horrible accident. In a great big atomic furnace, whoa! They thought for certain that I was dead. But I came out with a magic line head. Nine heads, you know. I had two arms when I walked in there. One on the left and one on the right. When I walked out, I had four more. Hey, wait a minute.
What's happening? We're losing power. What is it, Scarlet? What's happening?
I'm not sure, Captain.
Jones, what in the name of all that's sellable are you doing here?
I just realized, Captain, if Bloater stole the Boiling Hell, then it wasn't my fault we lost the ship at all, was it? None of this was my fault.
That's right, Jones. We all owe you an apology. Now get back to the boiler.
Thank you, Captain. I feel so much better now. I was beginning to lose faith in myself. Oh, I was in a horrible accident. In a great big atomic furnace.
Catch it in time. One.
As for you, Bladder, it's a lifetime of service in the stamp-licking colonies, after you've rolled this disgusting latex cloaking device off my ship.
I just wanted to be your best friend. I just wanted you all to myself.
And for that, you are willing to slaughter the thousands of Mission Control? Oh, what a tangled web you wove, Bladder. I almost envy you, Bleeper. At least you are up there among the stars. Captain's diary. Another uneventful day. A few small latex stains on the ship's paintwork. Oh, yes. Scarlet bought me a nice new alarm clock.